What you know about this though? What you know about going to like the rich area and they just leaving the candy out and saying take one? And you just take the whole bucket.
You walk out there like, go.
What's going on, everybody? We are back with another segment of Rappers React. Smoke diggity dog. Hold on. I am your
friend.
Close.
Uh-huh.
I guess I wouldn't say I'm your this, but
what you should have said was, if I was hiding under your bed, what would I be?
If I was hiding under your bed, what would I be?
A stalker.
God, this fool still ain't get it.
Oh, that's not right.
No.
What about a boogeyman?
You got it, my friend. Guys, before we get started, please do us a big, big, big favor. Y'all, please hit that thumbs up button. Guys, please, please subscribe to the channel.
And for God's sake, leave us a comment. And tell us what to react to next, because that's how we get the ideas for these videos. It comes directly from you right down in the comment section. And today, we are in the midst of the 13 days of Halloween, and we are about to cover Rob Zombie.
Yes, good old Rob Zombie, White Zombie.
Yes.
What? I mean, guys, just grab your closest dictionary, look up the word innovative.
Oh yeah.
You will see a picture of this man.
Look up brilliant, man. Look up creative. Yeah. Jesus.
I mean, we could go on and on and on and on and on.
Yes.
You know, it's but you know, with it being the 13 days of Halloween. Oh, I didn't even notice that.
You didn't even know you were wearing the shirt.
Bro, that's crazy. I didn't even notice that. See, that's how the universe works. But yes, one of my favorite movies of all time, House of a Thousand Corpses, directed by this man right here, Rob Zombie. But no, man, again, all right, Halloween, probably my favorite time of the year.
Oh, yeah.
Now, you got all the ghouls and the goblins and the ghosts, mm-hmm, and you know, the poltergeist, mm-hmm, and the demons and all these, you know, scary things.
Mm-hmm.
But have you ever seen a Halloween costume as the boogeyman? What does the boogeyman look like? Not the WWE character.
Yeah.
But what does the boogeyman look like?
That was a good boogeyman, though.
Ellie. Pretty good boogeyman.
Yeah.
A spoonful of sugar. You seen that? A spoonful of sugar.
Lots of medicine, go down. But yeah, man. I was thinking you were gonna say you hardly ever see a real good zombie costume. I mean, you do see them from time to
time.
Well,
nowadays, I would say you would. Yeah, just because of,
a lot
like,
more nowadays, yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
because of Walking Dead. Things like that, yeah.
I mean, you basically could just be a human, put some scars over you,
I know,
darken your skin grayish or whatever.
Yeah, exactly.
Rip off some of your clothes.
A zombie.
But boogeyman.
The boogeyman. See, that's up to your depiction, right? I mean, your own interpretation of whatever it could be. Because is there any set, you know, work of art throughout history that says this is the boogeyman? You know what I think? I think a lot of times of the blackened shadow figure with the horns, you know, and really not too much detail, you know, just this black figure with horns, you know,
right? Like a tulpe, or I guess something that's something you create.
Yeah,
but yeah, I get what you're saying.
Uh-huh.
Let me ask you, when you were growing up, were you afraid of the dark or afraid of going in your closet or?
No.
You weren't afraid of none of that?
Not necessarily.
Do you remember that show Unsolved Mysteries?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Whenever loved that... Loved it. Dude, I ran when that show came on, bro.
Dude, there was something, especially as a kid, though, that was creepy, dude.
Dude.
Just the music played into it and the dude's voice, like, there was something really scary about that movie about that show as a kid.
As a kid, yeah. There's two things for me. That show, and whenever I just remember it coming on like 9 or 10 o'clock at night, and you hear,
yeah,
you know what
exactly,
that is?
Yeah,
X-Files.
Yeah,
I hated that's theme music from the X-Files,
and it always came in right when you're about to fall asleep
every time.
Uh-huh.
And you're like, oh Lord, turn the TV off, man.
Dude, there was another one that Twilight Zone.
Dude, Twilight is genius.
Yeah,
I don't think Twilight Zone gets the credit for being such a good show, man.
Oh yeah,
I mean, it's a good show.
Oh man. But yeah,
Boogieman.
All Boogieman. Right.
All right. So real quick, I want to say, if you, all right, it's so weird. Like you, it makes you think. Where does that come from? Like, where does the whole? Because of course your parents say, if you don't eat your vegetables,
the Boogieman will get you.
Who? I wish I knew what I knew now. And my mom said that to me. I'm like, where can I meet this guy? Where, I want to know what he looks like.
Well, if you go back into like Scotch Irish culture, and there was. I believe it was called the Boogeyman.
Really?
Yeah, and I think that might have been an American adaptation calling it the Boogeyman.
Hmm. Maybe you're right, and the American, maybe the Irish, they had Boogeyman as someone who actually boogied and got down, and then America was like, nah, we're not going to have that much fun. That's just equated.
Dancing is of the devil, you know.
Dude, did you hear? You know about that?
About what?
There was this huge
Oh, yeah, yeah. The people that dance themselves to death.
They dance themselves to death.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe that has something to do with the Boogeyman. Hysteria.
Man, you know, I never thought to make that connection, but good choice.
Good observation there.
Man.
we could sit here and talk about Rob Zombie.
The Boogeyman got him and they couldn't stop dancing.
Seriously, that was the awesome. Boogeyman. He you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Smart up!
What up?
Let's get into it.
Let's do it.
Ooh, that's funky.
Yeah.
Bro, even the artwork looks kinda similar, right?
Yeah. So I guess this is a cover. Of the Casey and the Sunshine, I'm your Boogeyman.
A cover?
Yeah. What I am.
It is a This is Casey and the Sunshine Band.
Yeah.
Like he's whispering.
I know, yeah.
Dude, that drum and bass in the back is dope.
Oh, I know, yeah.
Dope.
That is dope. That guitar is amazing.
It is.
Rob Zombie, you have done it again, my friend.
I know. Gotta love it, man. Love it.
Mr. Zombie, you have done it again.
Oh, man. I love, like, everything we've heard about Rob Zombie is, like, beat-driven. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I bet when he goes to create a song, he starts with the beat.
Yeah.
You know, kind of like we do in hip-hop. That's what I was going to. You always start with the beat.
When you make your beats, did you normally start out with
the drum pattern?
You start with the drums first?
Oh, yeah.
See, I do opposite.
Really?
Yeah, I always start with the melody first.
Yeah, see, I always started with the drums.
Hmm. That's what, I guess, makes the contrast work.
But then again, like, you got to think, this song was a cover of an old funk song by KC and the Sunshine Band. Yeah, so, of course, you're going to start with the beat because funk was beat-driven, of course, you know. And you always had to add the instruments to syncopate with the beat, you know, where you always had that drive on the one, then a drive on the two, and a drive on the one.
Yep.
And,
man. All right, listening to this song, you know how it had that funky bass and drum.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think that was an actual person playing it, or do you think that was on a drum machine?
I think that was probably a drum machine.
I would say so myself.
Sounded like it to me, yeah.
Now, as far as that guitar, now, that dude,
came in and laid it in correct, yeah.
Here's a question for the Trash Talkers. Does Rob Zombie play any instruments? Have you ever seen him play a guitar?
I don't think so, that I've ever seen.
I don't think I've ever seen that either, but that's what I want to know. I mean, if he plays, you know, keyboard, flute, clarinet.
Maybe he plays the beat machine.
Maybe he's a beat machine phenomenon.
Maybe that's why, you know, so much of his music has been electronically driven, you know?
Yeah, possibly. Man, guys, with it being 13 days of Halloween, man, one thing that I'm not the biggest fan of sweets. You like sweets?
Not really. Of course I did as a kid. Yeah. But yeah, nowadays not so much.
Dude, I swear, things have changed, man. Remember when we were kids, man, and we'd go trick-or-treating and come back with pillowcases full of...
Oh, yeah.
I feel like it's not like that anymore.
Yeah, I don't think so. I mean, people are scared to send their kids to a lot of houses these days, you know?
Man, I don't know, dude.
Remember back when we were kids, your parents would be like, yeah, get on out there and trick-or-treat. They didn't watch you.
No, bro.
Like, nowadays, you ain't going to see a trick-or-treater come up to the door without the parents standing there.
Yeah, or standing behind in the car
or something. Exactly, yeah.
And in my neighborhood, I get a fair amount of trick-or-treaters, so I try to hand out candy, you know, at least every year. But one thing I will say, man, as a kid, during Halloween, I looked forward to it so much because we were just deviant little assholes.
Yeah, I'll tell you.
I mean, we would, bro, true story, we would bury eggs underground for a week just to throw them at people or throw them at cars, and they stink. I swear we would do that. While everybody else is over there toilet papering houses, we're over here burying eggs under the ground to hit you with some of the foulest smelling thing you've ever smelled in your life.
See, I remember back in the neighborhood, like, I don't think we were going that far, but what we would do is, like, dress up. Like, we'd have, like, four or five different costumes and hit all the houses over and over.
Then y'all swap costumes?
Because there wasn't no parents driving you from neighborhood to neighborhood.
We were on our bike.
Do now. Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, you just go around the neighborhoods that are closest to you. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Yeah. What you know about this, though? What you know about going to, like, the rich area and they just leaving the candy out and saying, take one? You just take the whole bucket.
You walk up there and, like,
go!
You dump the whole bucket in your bag and run.
And then we ain't talking about no bite size. We talking about a king size snicker here.
Yeah, man, I don't know. I ain't hit too many rich neighborhoods when I was a kid, but them king size sounded good.
Yeah, boy. And then you come back and be like, hey, bro, I'll trade you.
We got them tiny little bite size, little micro pieces.
Like, what am I going to do with that, man? Then you get back with your homeboys, you divvy it up. You're like, hey, bro, I see you got them Twizzlers over there. I'll trade you two M&Ms, three 9-laters, and I might throw in these nasty Whoppers for that. Did you like Whoppers?
Yeah.
I love Whoppers.
I like the Whoppers. I like the Kit Kats. You don't like the wafers and the...
No, Kit Kats are amazing.
Oh, yeah?
You know what Whoppers are?
Yeah, why you don't like Whoppers?
That's disgusting, Smokey.
See, I wasn't into Twizzlers or anything.
Now, I love Twizzlers. Everyone says it's like wax.
See, for you to say that, though, like, everybody has... Like, some people like, candy corn is just nasty. And some people like, I love it. Like, oh, it's that taste.
It don't bother me. I don't know. I'm one of the people...
I mean, you can't just say, oh, that's completely disgusting, yet they sell millions of it.
You're right.
You know?
It's me. And I'm not... It's tolerable. I can eat it. But it's just, like, the crunchiness of it. It's just... I don't know. It's weird.
I always liked it because... You put them in your mouth and let all the chocolate melt off, and then you got the... What did they call the inside?
Malt.
The malt. Yeah, the malt ball. The moth ball.
Oh, man.
That would be a Halloween prank. You just dip the moth balls in chocolate.
Already. Guys, listen, I hope you guys are enjoying your 13 days of Halloween. Everyone, be safe. If you're sending your kids out to trick-or-treat, make sure everyone stays safe. Social distance, you know, just go out there and... Have fun, but be safe at the same time.
Man, it is hard. Well, I guess you could social distance and trick-or-treat, right?
Yeah, I was talking to a really good friend of mine, and she had said what a lot of neighborhoods are doing. They're getting PVC pipes and just, like, out their window, and they'll just have it down there and just slide the candy.
Yeah.
I mean, dude, it's 2020.
All you got to do is set the candy up for, like, a couple of days. I mean, I know the kids are going to want to dig into it right when they get it.
Uh-huh.
But if you got somebody with the stuff, you know, and they're over there with this big bag and they're breathing all over, you know, the bucket, and they're giving it to the kids, and you might want to let it sit up for a few days before the kids get into it.
Yeah.
That's going to be hard. I mean, because, you know, when your kids get back, they're going to dump it all out on the floor.
Man.
Be like, what you got? What you got?
Y'all be careful on Halloween, man.
Mm-hmm.
And because I know I've also heard horror stories. My mom always told me growing up, and I feel like I say that a lot. I feel like I am a mama's boy. I always say my mama said this. Yes, this is what my mama said. You never eat candy that doesn't have wrap or doesn't have a sealed wrapper or a label. Because I don't know if this happened where you guys are from, but here in Atlanta, you remember they were putting like needles.
Mm-hmm.
You remember that in like candy?
Yeah. Well. They could do that with the sealed ones because it makes such a small hole. They just shove it in there. You never see the hole. But I was reading a statistic about that, too, and they said it's actually extremely rare that it ever happened, but it has happened, but not very often. You know, it's not like, I don't know, one out of every 10 million, you know, that's, that has happened or whatever.
That's just the hysteria your parents put on you.
Well, you know, and it happens one time, and it's going to go around, and... Parents are going to be like, nah, no more trick-or-treating.
Yeah. Everyone, again, enjoy your 13 days of Halloween. And with that being said, y'all, my name's Behringer Hollywood, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Bye. I am Larry Smokey Ramirez Cowan.
And we are
over.
Yeah.
Out. Deuces. I want to thank you guys for tuning in to Rappers React today. If you want to see another artist that we covered, it's right over here. If you want to see the last video we did, it's right over here. Thank you guys for tuning in. We do this for you. Please go ahead and hit that subscribe button if you will. Give us a thumbs up, and we'll see you on the next one. Deuces.